Took so many years, I'm just waiting for the wins. I'm in debt to no one but the one who took my sins. I do it for real, there's no reason to pretend. If I do it once, I do it again. Add it up, add it up. Bankroll, bankroll, euro, euro, peso, peso, add it up, add it up. I'm just doing me, everything is on me. Oh, you matter what? What's going on YouTube? Real quick, in the comments down below, let me know what sport you rocked with growing up, or if you're still in high school, what sports are you into? If you didn't play sports, what was your go-to hobbies? For me, I was kind of a natural athlete. I was pretty good at everything that I played. I was never the best at any particular sport, but I was pretty good across the board. And on my downtime, if you can call it a hobby, was to play video games. That's what I like to do. I still like to do it to this day. So let me know in the comments down below, and in the next video, we'll pick a random winner from the comment section. Like I said, man, I want to see some new faces. Be a part of the community, especially if you already watched the videos, and especially if you're sub. Don't be afraid to comment, man. You got nothing to lose. Go ahead and be a part of the giveaway. That's what I want to see. That's why we're trying to grow and just build a big community and everybody gets involved. That's the goal right there. So what I want to get into today is something that I don't see a lot of Madden players talking about. And I think it's because there's not that much of an understanding for it. And what I'm talking about is the pass rushing points versus the O-lineman's resistant points. I don't think a lot of people understand it because, like I said, I haven't seen a lot of people talk about it. So we're going to jump into the practice field and I'm going to give you a better understanding about this system. And I guarantee you, after you get an understanding for it, it might change the way you play on defense, because it's made an impact. Like, I knew how to pass rush with the user on the D-line, but I never really got into it to understand it. And once you understand it, I guarantee you it might change the way you play, especially for like third downs and things like that. So let's go ahead and jump into the practice field and I can show y'all what I'm talking about. All right, I want you to pay attention to Aaron Donald. Above Aaron Donald, there's five green bars lit up. That's your pass rush points. Now underneath the old lineman, I don't know if you could tell, underneath the left guard in the center, there's a little orange bar. It's like a little box. Those are resistance points for the old lineman. Now the way they gain their resistance points is if you keep doing the same thing over and over again, or you keep doing the same play. You know, they adapt to it and they learn it and they gain resistance, so they get better pass blocking. For pass rushers, you know, the way they gain their resistance bars back is over time. Even if they're having a bad game, after plays go on and on, they'll gain their bars back. But if they're doing good and they're getting sacks and they're getting successful block sheds, they'll gain their bars back like that as well. Not everybody can get five bars like Aaron Donald. For example, this guy right here, he can only get a max of three bars. Another example, this guy right here, he can only get a max of two bars. The way I was able to bring his bars up is you got to come up to the line. If they're gray above the green bars, that means you can't get more than what you have now. Whenever you use a pass rush point, it'll turn white. That means you're missing a bar. And this is why El Toro is so good, especially with somebody like Aaron Donald. Whenever you have all five bars maxed up, you're maxed out, you're basically going to get a free pass rush against whoever you're going against. You're going to instantly get through them with the bull rush, and I'll show you what I'm talking about, and I'll show you how to set up a 1-4-6 play to where it's always going to be one-on-one with you in the center, even if you're just sending three guys. What you're going to do is you're going to pinch your D-line and your linebackers, and then the other linebacker that's blitzing, put them on a quarterback contain. So this is a crazy third down play whenever you have somebody that can bull rush like this. You don't necessarily need somebody with El Toro, but basically anybody that has like inside stuff, basically the big guys that don't do speed rushing moves, they can do the bull rush move and get to the quarterback. Will they be successful as much as Aaron Donald? Probably not, but I'm going to show you how you get one-on-one with the center almost every time out of a 1-4-6 play. This is a great third down play. I definitely use it even with the Ravens. Like, I'll use this with Earl Campbell. I'll put him in the middle and I'll try to get that bull rush in. So let's go ahead and set up the play and you'll see what I'm talking about. So this is what it looks like. Normally this linebacker will come down here like this, and it'll look like you have five down like that. And then we're going to blitz and easily get to the quarterback. You see how quick he just got through the line like that? That's because you basically get a free pass rush against whoever you're going against, as long as it's one-on-one. And setting up your defense like that is going to allow you to get that one-on-one every single time with the center. Now you can see I didn't lose any pass rush points because it was successful and I got a sack. the game is really good at rewarding you when you do good. So, you know, you might see those games where you're like, man, Aaron Donald went off, or this guy went off. It's because he kept doing good and he kept receiving his points back. So he might have had a really good game. For the offensive linemen, they can gain resistance. Now, some offensive linemen can gain more resistance than others. Like the center I'm going against, he can only gain 2. Now, that's terrible. Even if he was maxed out on both his resistance and he's going to get somebody like Aaron Donald, I'm going to get through him every single time when I have all 5 of my bars maxed out. Even if I don't have all 5 maxed out, do I have a better chance if they are maxed out? Of course. But you can still, even if I only have 1 pass rush bar left, I can still get through somebody like the center for the Ravens. It's going to take somebody like 85 overall or better with some type of resistant bars to actually stop Aaron Donald. And even at that, when I have my stuff maxed out, I'm probably still going to get through you. Like, for example, when you first start off a Ravens game, I guarantee you your first 2 pass rushes, you're going to get, if they do a passing play on the first 2 downs, you'll get through instantly with this play that I'm telling you to do out of the 1-4-6. You don't need to necessarily use this play, but if you want to get one-on-one every time, this is your go-to. Now, there's other players that have like edge threat. You can do the same thing with them. You just got to figure out what's their go-to move. And if you don't know what moves to do, you can hold LT and they'll pop up. You can see right there, it says pass rush moves. Up with the right stick is a rip. Down with the right stick, which what I'm using, is a bull rush. Left or right with the right stick is a club or a swim move. RT is a speed rush. LT is a contain. Down to the left or down to the right is a spin move. That's when you do the double team. When you're getting double team, you want to do that spin move down with the left or down with the right. Now, another thing where people might mess up a lot of people, they're trying to rush and have they're holding the boost or the turbo. That's not what you want to do. If you're holding RT when you're blitzing, they're going to automatically put you into a speed rush. Not everybody's good at speed rushing. That's when you're on the edge. That's people like Nick Bosa. You don't want to do a speed rush with somebody like Aaron Donald. So you might mess up by holding RT thinking you're just trying to get to the quarterback faster. Don't do that because it's going to mess up your bull rush. Make sure you make your bull rush. I'll show you. Make sure you do your bull rush first. Let him call a hut. Make sure you do your bull rush first and then sprint to the quarterback. You can see one of my bars went away, but since I got the sack, my bar is going to go back. Now, this is another reason. Since he's lit up like this, I'm going to tell you about his X factor. Now, what his X factor does is kind of OP. So basically, whenever I'm lit up with Aaron Donald, everybody on the O-line resistant bars are wiped clean. So that means I'm maxed out. I'm getting to the quarterback every single time. I'm maxed out on my bars. I have my X factor. It don't matter who's in front of you. If you don't got no resistant bars against Aaron Donald, about to do a bull rush one-on-one, I'm going to get to the quarterback every time. There's no resistant bars. I'm going to get to him. Watch. Put my linebacker on a quarterback contain or a quarterback spy every single time. And this works online. As y'all can see the highlights in the beginning, that was just one game. And I only played to the second half. And I got to the quarterback even more than that. But I was just showing you some of them. So, you know, that's why I wanted to show y'all. That's how it works. Like I said, you don't need somebody like Aaron Donald, but when is it not great to have somebody like Aaron Donald to do this with? I went out there and played some head-to-head games just to get the experience, and man, that's some of the most fun I had, just getting through the line, getting to the quarterback, having that quarterback spy. Every time they try to get outside the pocket, I sent my spy at them, got a sack. I don't know how many picks they've thrown from bad balls. I'm telling y'all right now, like, go to the practice field. Get the best person that you have on your favorite team that can pass rush, learn his moves, and use him on a third down, like a third and long. Run this 1-4-6 defense, put a quarterback spy, you know, leave the safety over the top, leave the other safety in the middle of the field, or change the zones up however you want. But I'm telling you, use this on third down, you'll get some stops. I love this defense. I'm still experiencing with the abilities for defensive linemen, but I'm definitely getting the hang of it, and it's definitely changed the way I play the game. All right, YouTube, that's gonna be it for this video. I hope y'all can learn something from this. I'm not gonna lie to y'all, man. The more and more, you know, I was experimenting with this, I was learning and learning. And like I said, I've never been the type to be a user for the D-line. I've always been like a linebacker and a safety. But, you know, getting a better understanding on how the point system works has really made me, you know, utilize my defensive linemen a lot more. Mostly for like the third down plays, third and long, and if they go for it on fourth, those are the times, you know, you're going to get most of your one-on-ones and you can get to the quarterback a lot quicker. I hope y'all enjoyed this video, though. Like I said, I hope y'all can learn something from it. If you're watching the videos, man, you're not subbed, help your boy out. Let's continue to grow. We're almost there at 500. That's the goal right now. And then from there, the next big goal is going to be 1,000. Hey, the more and more we grow, the bigger and bigger the giveaways are going to be. Be a part of the community. Like I said, don't be afraid to comment. Let's get this thing going. Like always, like, comment, subscribe. Let's get it.